Welcome to How to Goth. This is your three-step guide on how to goth without being a pretentious asshole. Now you may be asking yourself, what gives this girl the authority to instruct me on how to goth? Well, I don't consider myself so much as an authority, but I have been a goth for 20 plus years and I've never once had to step on the emotions of others to make myself feel better. Step number one, don't force your opinion on anyone. Everybody has their preferences. Some people like coffee, some people like crack, but we're all essentially part of the same subculture. It's the differences that make us unique and interesting. Opinions are like assholes. Everybody has one, but nobody wants you to shove yours in their face. Step number two, do impart wisdom. New finds, old haunts, tell people where you got your boots, but do not roll your eyes and scoff if somebody asks you a question. It's all about inclusion, making people feeling welcome and accepted. Encourage others, share your wisdom. Catch more flies with honey than you do with vinegar. Plus, what the hell do you get out of being a bitch anyway? Step number three, watch the attitude. You think you may know more than someone else, but keep it to yourself. It's condescending and it makes people feel bad. Do you find yourself rolling your eyes a lot? Do you look at yourself in the presence of others and think, I'm better than most of these people? Do you look at the majority of those around you and think, what a bunch of fucking posers? Don't go outside. Take a break from the internet and try and go somewhere where you can learn some humility. Now, if you fit the aforementioned criteria and you often find yourself wondering about the dwindling numbers in the goth scene, I would take a look in the mirror because you are hardly presenting the picture of hospitality. And as for the rest of you, please do not allow these people to piss in your parade. Do not let them make you feel inadequate or unworthy to enjoy the very thing that you love. Otherwise, they've won. They're going to live, breathe, and die in their exclusive little bubble of pretension that they created. And while you're over here having the time of your life, they're going to be developing frown lines way before you do, because it takes far more muscles to frown than it does to smile.